Hello student, today I am going to teach class 7 subject history chapter 3 the Turkish invaders. Here you will learn about Turkish, how they have came in world. So let's start student. Arabs. First I will read this chapter, while reading I will explain it also. Arabs. The Arabs were the first Muslims conquerors of India in the beginning of CE 712. Sindh was attacked by the Arabs for the first time. Muhammad bin Qasim and Umayyad general conquered the region of Sindh and Punjab. As a result of this invasion, trade and culture contacts were established with Central Asia. Arabs attained religious and political unit in India by spreading Islam. Arabs could not extend their rule in India at the time because of the strong resistance put up by the Rajputs. It was from 8th century onward that the northern part of India gradually became weaker due to constant wars among the rulers. This is the picture of despite of Arab invention. From 1000 CE onward, Indian rulers were threatened by repeated invasion from the northern, northwestern side. Turks, the period from CE 1000 to 1200 saw changes in Central and West Asia and in India. It were these developments which led to the incursion of Turks into northern India toward the end of this period. Next topic is Muhammad of Ghazi. The Turks became a powerful force after the decline of the Abbasids. The Turks established the two major kingdoms of Ghazi and Ghor. Muhammad was the first Turkish invader who invaded India for the northwest western side. He was the ruler of Ghazi during the 33 years of the reign. The period of ruler of a monarch. He carried out 70 raids on India. He was interested in the wealth rather than setting up an empire in Indian subcontinent. This is a picture of empire of a Muhammad Ghazi. This is a picture of India where the Muhammad Ghazi have ruled in India. The next is Muhammad needed a lot of money to organize a well-equipped army in order to fulfill his desire of conquering Central Asia. He attacked India to plunder wealth, to take away wealth. The weak political condition of India attracted him most, as he did not face any tough resistance from Indian side. He carried on 17 attacks on India, one after the other from CE 1001 to CE 1025. Muhammad defeated Jaipal, the Hindu ruler of Punjab, in 1001 CE and forced him to pay tributes. Muhammad defeated the confederacy led by the Anandpal in the year 1008 to 1009 CE. His cavalry played a great role in the victory. He also invaded the plunder, the cities and the temple towns such as Multan, Alwar, Mathura, Nagarkot, Taneshwar and Somnath. The plunder of the Somnath temple CE 1025 brought. Muhammad never suffered his him impressed wealth. Muhammad never suffered a defeated. He annexed Punjab and thus opened the road for future invention of India. Dalbirin, a scholar, spent about 10 years in India and wrote book Kitab ul Hind. This book has description of India and its various facts. This book is a valuable source of information for historians. Ghazi proposed it as Muhammad drain and India, Indian countryside of its wealth to Muhammad of Ghazi. India was simple, a vast treasure state which could be plundered to make Ghazi powerful and rich. With the wealth of plundered from India, Muhammad honored his capital city with magnificent building, including museum, libraries, and mosque. His court glittered with jewels. The famous Persian poet Firdowsi wrote his epic Shahnama, which was a biography of Muhammad of Ghazi. Muhammad died in CE 1030. This ended his raid and plunder of India. His conquest, however, did not produce any permanent result as he failed to establish an empire in India. Student, as I have completed the half chapter, in next class we will do the half chapter. So, thank you, student.